With the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are now proceeding to read Surah Al-Ahzab. This is the Madani Surah after 8 Makki Surahs that we have read. After Surah Al-Nur, we had 8 Makki Surahs. Surah Al-Furqan, Surah Al-Shu'ara, Surah Al-Naml, Surah Al-Qasas, Surah Al-Ankabut, Surah Al-Rum, Surah Al-Ruqman, Surah Al-Sajda. And now this Surah Al-Ahzab. Just as we had 14 Makki Surahs and then Surah Al-Nur, starting from Surah Yusuf, Surah Yunus to Surah Mu'minun, there were 14 Makki Surahs, and then came the one Madani Surah, that was Surah Al-Nur. Here we had 8 Makki Surahs and then Surah Al-Ahzab. And I had told you there and then, when we were reading Surah Al-Nur, that although Surah Nur is also isolatory over there, no pair is there. And in the same way, there is no pair here of Surah Al-Ahzab. This is also solitary. But they are like sisters. They can be regarded as a very beautiful pair of surahs. Subjects are very similar. You know, the subject of hijab and covering of the bodies of for women, when they go out from these houses, is given in Surah Al-Ahzab. But what are the etiquettes of covering the bodies of women within the house? That is given in Surah An-Nur. So you have these similarities. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Size also is nearly very equal. 9 sections of Surah An-Nur, 9 sections of Surah Al-Ahzab. And you'll find, you know, the ayah number 35 of Surah An-Nur was very profound. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. The simile for the light of Nur that is there in the hearts of the believing people. But what is the outward reaction, outward result in the behavior? That is given in ayah number 35 of this surah. So there is a connection between ayah 35 in Surah An-Nur and ayah 35 of Surah Ahzab. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها النبي اتق الله ولا تطع الكافرين والمنافقين إن الله كان عليما حكيما. O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, fear Allah and obey nobody else except Him. ولا تطع الكافرين, don't obey these disbelievers, والمنافقين and the hypocrites. Verily Allah سبحانه وتعالى is all knowing, all wise. وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ, and follow whatever is being revealed to you from your Lord. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا, verily Allah is aware of what you are doing. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ, and have your faith and trust in Allah. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا, and Allah is sufficient as a guardian. مَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِرَجُلٍ مِنْ قَلْبَيْنِ فِي جَوْفِهِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not placed two hearts in the body of a man. وَمَا جَعَلَ أَزْوَاجَكُمُ اللَّهِ تُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْهُنَّ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ, and He has not accepted that when you say to your wife, you are like my mother to me, she doesn't become your mother, she's your wife. وَمَا جَعَلَ أَدْرَاكُمْ أَبْنَاكُمْ, and in the same way, your adopted sons whom you adopt, they are not your sons. ذَلِكُمْ خَوْلُكُمْ بِأَفْوَائِكُمْ, these are your words which you utter with your mouths. If you say to your wife, you are like my mother to me, well, it has no meaning. Wife is wife. Mother is the one who gave birth to you, not your wife. In the same way, your sons, the adopters, there is no concept of adoption in Islam. Islamic law doesn't accept it. وَاللَّهُ يَقُولُ الْحَقَّ وَهُوَ يَهْدِ السَّبِيلِ, Allah says whatever is true, and He guides you to this correct path, right way. Actually, there is a background of this surah, especially this first section, and then, you know, the details of that historical event will come in the second, third and fourth sections of this surah. The background is that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a slave, Zaid ibn Harisa. He had adopted him, freed him, adopted him as his son. Now he is called Zaid ibn Muhammad. But then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, there is no adoption in Islam, Uduhum le abaihim, you have to call them with the names of their fathers. So again, this Zaid ibn Harisa was called Zaid ibn Harisa. But this grieved him. Now, to console him, the Prophet ﷺ proposed that he should marry his own cousin, cousin of Muhammad ﷺ, daughter of a aunt, paternal aunt, granddaughter of Abu Abdul Muttalib, Zainab bint Jahash, radiallahu ta'ala anha. She was a mu'mina. Now, the Prophet proposed to Zainab and her family that they should accept Zaid and give Zainab in marriage to Zaid. The family was not ready because he had been a slave, although he has been now released from the slavery. Now he is a free man, but even then, you know, the status is not equal to a free man. He is Mawali. So they were not ready. But when the Prophet insisted, they agreed. So Zainab bint Jahash agreed to marry. But these husband and wife, they couldn't go together. Actually, Zainab couldn't give that respect to Zaid, which a wife should give to her husband. So they were not going, the family life was not going well. So Zaid decided to divorce her. Now the Prophet thought, in the beginning I compelled them that they should accept Zaid and they should give Zainab in marriage to Zaid. Now if Zaid divorces her, it will be a shock for them, absolutely a degradation. So now the only way of consoling Zainab would be that I should marry her myself. Then she will be consoled. First I compelled her to accept Zaid as her husband. She was reluctant. And now Zaid is divorcing him. So he kept saying to Zaid, keep her with you, don't divorce her. Things will be better. But he had in his mind that if he divorces, then there is no way other than he will have to marry her. But what will happen? What will people say? Well, Zaid was his adopted son. So she is the wife of the adopted son. And according to the Arabian customs, adopted son was just equal to son. So people will, you know, raise a hoo and cry. What has happened to this person? He says he is a prophet, he is a messenger of Allah. And he is going so low, he is marrying the divorced wife of his own son, adopted son. So that was the fear that Muhammad had in mind. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted that this matter should be settled once for all. That adopted sons are nothing and no relations can become forbidden due to this adoption. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the heavens, He decided that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marry Hazrat Zainab. So this is the historical background of this surah. وَدُوهُمْ لِعَبَائِهِمْ, call them with the names of their fathers, the adopted sons. You should say Zaid ibn Muhammad. You should say Zaid ibn Harisa. هو أَقْسَطُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, that is most equitable in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَبَاهُمْ, and if you don't know their fathers, who are their fathers? Just as in this society, now many people don't know who were their fathers. So now they say, okay, tell us the name of your mother. So but here, you know, maybe there could be someone whose father was unknown. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَبَاهُمْ, if you don't know their fathers, فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ, even then they are your brothers in deen, in religion. وَمَوَالِيكُمْ, and they are friends. وَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ فِي مَا أَخْطَأْتُمْ بِهِ, and there is no blame on you if you have sometimes mistaken. وَلَكِمْ مَا تَعَمَّدَتْ قُلُوبَكُمْ, but whatsoever you earn with the intentions of your hearts, that is, for that you will be held responsible. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمًا, and verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving, merciful. النَّبِيُّ أَوْلَى بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ, the Prophet is closer and dearer to all the believers than their own selves, than their own lives. وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ And his wives are like mothers to them. أَزْوَاجُ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَرَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ عَنْهُنَّ They are the mothers of the Ummah. Ummul Mu'mineen, Ummul Mu'mineen, Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha, Ummul Mu'mineen Hafsa, Ummul Mu'mineen Ummu Salama. They are all mothers. They are mothers for this Ummah. وَأُولُو الْأَرْحَامِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلَىٰ بِبَعْضٍ And those who are related by blood relations, relations of the womb of the mothers, well, they are closer to each other, فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ in the divine law, in Sharia, مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ than the other believers and the muhajireen. But, إِلَّا أَن تَفْعَلُوا إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَاكُمْ مَعْرُوفًا You can do good to your friends. Well, there was someone muhajir, he was declared to be brother of an Ansari, you do good to him. But he will not be inheritor. Inheritor will be only your own sons and your own daughters and so on and so forth. They will not be included in the inheritance. This is there in Surah Al-Anfal also. إِلَّا أَن تَفَعَلُوا إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَاكُمْ مَعْرُوفًا During your lifetime, you can do any good to them. You can gift them, you can help them. كَانَ ذَلِكَ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَسْتُورًا This has already been inscribed in the book. وَإِذَا أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ And when we took a covenant from all the prophets, وَمِنْكَ And we took it from you also, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَمِنْ نُوحٍ And from Nuh, وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ And Ibrahim, وَمُوسَى And Musa, وَإِسَى Isa ibn Maryam, And from the Isa, son of Maryam, وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا And we had taken from all of them a very solemn covenant. This covenant we have read in Surah Ali Imran. There's the detail. لِيَسْأَلُ الصَّادِقِينَ عَنْ صِدْقِهِمْ So that Allah would question the truthful peoples regarding their truth. وَعَدَّ لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا But He has prepared for the disbelievers a very painful chastisement. Now in the two sections that are coming, there is a narration of the conditions of Ghazwatul Ahzab, the Battle of the Trenches. The background is that after Uhud, now the people of Quraysh mostly, they were not thinking that they should invade again. But the Jews who had been turned out from Medina, Banu Qainqa, Banu Nuzair, they conspired. They went to Khaybar and asked the Jews of Khaybar, they should come and invade Medina. They went to Makkah. They said, Oh Quraysh, you try again, once again, we shall help you from inside. But you try it. And even they went to the eastern side of Arabia, Banu Ghatfan, of the tribes of the Najd. And they, you know, included them also in this conspiracy. So as a result, an army of 12,000 people came and surrounded Medina. It was a very big event. A small township, not a town even, a small township, a few thousand people living over there. And 12,000 men surrounding it, fully equipped with all the machinery for their war and what the weapons that they needed. So this was the hardest test for the believers, whether they forbear it, persevere, they stand firm, loyal to Allah and His Messenger, or if there is any disease in their hearts, it shows out. So this is actually what we read yesterday, last night, in Surah Al-Ankabut. أَحَسَبَ النَّاسُ وَيُتْرَكُوا يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ And then later, وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ Allah is going to make distinct who is a real believer, true believer, and who is a hypocrite. And only after testing you can know it. Otherwise, they are intermingled with each other. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who believe, recall, اُذْكُرُوا, recall, نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ The blessing of Allah that came to you. إِذْ جَاتْكُمْ جُنُودٌ When many armies came over you, not jund, junood. Now this is because a conglomeration of these armies. Someone had come from south, from Mecca. Others had come from north, coming from Khaybar. And the third group had come from the east, from Najd. Is jatkum junoodun. When armies came over you, فَارْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا. What happened actually, about for 1 month, there was a sort of standoff between two armies, because the advice was given by Salman Farsi رضي الله تعالى عنه, that in such conditions, when it becomes difficult to fight your enemy in the open field, in Iran, in Persia, we dig trenches to save ourselves, defend ourselves beyond these trenches, before these trenches. So the trenches were dug by the command of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam under the advice of Salman Farsi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they couldn't cross it. So they stayed there for about a month. But then a very big, you know, a wind came, very strong wind, and it took away their tents, etc. And you know, the huts on which they were cooking their meals, you know, due to that fire, you know, whole the camps, you know, got ablaze and caught fire, and then they went away without achieving anything. Only two or three, you know, people came by, you know, crossing this trench. But you know, then there was one Abd ibn Wad. He was a very big and, you know, very brave person, 90 years old. And he used to be called the bravest man in Arabia. So he came over and he said, okay, let somebody come and meet me. Hazrat Ali came forward, radiallahu ta'ala. Now Hazrat Ali was of short stature. And just young man, he laughed. Who are you? You want to fight me? He said, yes. Okay. Then he said, I give three wishes to a person who comes to fight with me, so that I can grant any of his wish. Do you have any wishes? Ali said, yes. My first wish is you become Muslim. I said, no. Nothing doing. Okay. My second is you go back from this fight. I said, no. Third, Ali said, okay, come and fight me. And he was astonished. Oh, I never thought there is any person in this world who can invite me. Come and fight me. But he was put to death by Hazrat Ali رضي الله عنه, sent to the hell. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ جَاءَتْكُمْ جُنُودًا فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا. We sent a wind over them. وَجُنُودًا لَمْ تَرَوْهَا. And we sent armies which you couldn't see, armies of angels. وَقَانَ اللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرًا. And verily, whatever you were doing, Allah was seeing. إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ. When they come over you from above you, that is from the north, from Khaybar. وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ. And from lower area of Arabia from you, and that was Hijaz, down to Makkah. إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْأَبْصَارُ. And when the eyes swerved, وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرَ, and the hearts, you know, in fear, they reached the throats. وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ الظُّنُونَ. And now you were having doubts about Allah in your minds. هُنَالِكَ ابْتُلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. At that time, the believers were tried. وَزُلْزِلُوا زِلْزَالًا شَدِيدًا. And they were shaken with a severe shaking. With the result that, وَإِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ. Now the munafiqeen, they said, وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِ مَرَضٌ. And those in whose hearts was a disease, مَا وَعَدَنَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. Whatever promises were made to us by Allah and His Messenger, they have proved to be false promises. Muhammad had promised us that we shall conquer Rome and we shall conquer Persia, and we shall have, you know, lot of bounties and booties and everything. What has happened to us? Now it seems the game is finished. We are in no way in a position to fight this host of 12,000 people. Whole of Arabia, so to say, has joined hands against us. The Jews from the north, the Quraysh from the south, and Banu Ghatfan from the east, very fierce fighters. So their nifaq, their hypocrisy that came out from their hearts, from their tongues. وَإِسْقَالَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَا عَلَى يَسْرَبْ. And some of them were saying, oh, people of Yasrib. Yasrib was the name of Medina before Muhammad came over there, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَا مَقَامَ لَكُمْ. There's no stand for you. Now you can't stand here. It's impossible. You can't fight this army. فَرْجِعُوا. Go back. وَيَسْتَعْجَنُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ. And some of the people among them, they were asking the permission an Nabiya from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَقُولُونَ, saying, إِنَّ بُيُوتَنَا عَرَى. Our houses are exposed. Maybe we are here and the enemy comes and attacks our houses. Our women folk are there, our children are there. So please give us the permission, we go and guard our houses. وَمَا هِيَ بِعَوْرَى. And they were not exposed. إِن يُرِيدُونَ إِلَّا فِرَارًا. Only what they wanted was to flee from the battlefield. وَلَوْ دُخِلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ أَقْطَارِهَا. And if an entrance had been forced against them by the enemy from all sides, from Masoil al-Fitna, and then they were taken, they were asked to sedition and renegade. You leave Islam and come back, and you should stand in revolt against Muhammad. مَا تَلَبْ لَعَاتَوْهَا وَمَا تَلَبَّسُوا بِهَا إِلَّا يَسِيرًا. They would have certainly accepted it, and would have not hesitated about it but slightly. This is the condition of the munafiqeen. وَلَقَدْ كَانُوا عَهَدُ اللَّهَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And they had been promising Allah beforehand. They had made a firm covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا يُوَلُّونَ الْأَدْبَارِ. They will not turn their backs from the battlefields. وَكَانَ عَهَدُ اللَّهِ مَسْئُولًا. And verily the covenant made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be asked about. What did you do with that covenant? You fulfill it or you broke it? قُلْ لَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْفِرَارِ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this flight from this battlefield will not be able to give you any benefit. In farartum min al-maut, if you want to fly away from death, death can come into your houses. Are you sure death will not come? The angel of death cannot enter your house. Habil qatl or slaughter. Wa'izallah tumatta'una illa qaleela. Even if you are not killed here, but you have to die. You cannot hope to live forever in this world. قُلْ مَنْ ذَلَّذِي يَعْصِمُكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Tell them, who is the one who can save you and protect you against Allah? إِنْ أَرَادَ بِكُمْ سُوًا. If Allah intends something bad for you, أَوْ أَرَادَ بِكُمْ رَحْمَةً. And if Allah intends some mercy for you, who can stop it? وَلَا يَجِدُونَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلِيًّا وَلَا نَصِيرًا. And they will not find besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any protector or no friend. قَدْ يَعْلَمُ اللَّهُ الْمُعَوِّقِينَ مِنْكُمْ. Allah very well knows those who hinder others. Don't go. وَالْقَائِلِينَ لِإِخْوَانِهِمْ. And who say to their brothers, هَلُمَّ إِلَيْنَا. Come back to us. Come back from the battlefield. وَلَا يَعْتُونَ الْبَعْثَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they themselves don't go there to the battlefield, but only very little. For a while they came and then went back, slipped away. أَشِيْحَةً عَلَيْكُمْ. They are very miserly for you, O Mu'mineen, O believers. They don't want that any good should come to you. فَإِذَا جَعَى الْخَوْفُ رَأَيْتَهُمْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْكُمْ تَدُورُ أَعْيُنُهُمْ كَالَّذِي يُخْشَى عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْمَوْتِ. When there is a condition of fear and danger, you will see them looking to you, their eyes rolling like one who swoons of death. If death is coming, you know, and the eyes are going to this direction, that direction, this is the condition, because they care very much for their lives. And when, you know, there is a fighting, there is the risk of life. فَإِذَا ذَهَبَ الْخَوْفِ. And when that fear has gone, سَلَقُوكُمْ بَيَلْسِنَةٍ حِدَادٍ. Now they attack you with very sharp tongues. أَشِيْحَةٍ عَلْ الْخَيْرِ. Being covetous of the best spoils that you have. أُولَٰئِكَ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا. Actually, these people never believed. They said they believed, they were not true believers. They had the guise of Islam only. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. You know, this is the first ayah of the second section of Surah Al-Baqarah. Three categories of people discussed in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. The true mu'mineen, and this is their character. Then those who had decided finally not to accept Islam. And for them it is equal, whether you warn them or not. Kuffar. Khatamallahu ala qulubihim. On their hearts, a seal has been put. And third is the category in between. They say we are Muslim and well, believers, but they are not Muslims. Ulaika lam yu'minu fa'ahbatallahu a'malahum. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made all their good deeds fruitless. What does it mean? They have been praying, offering prayers under the imamah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the mosque of the Prophet. These were good deeds. But actually, because they didn't have the real faith in their hearts, so all their good deeds have gone in vain. Fruitless. وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرًا. And this is very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَحْسَبُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ لَمْ يَذْهَبُوا. When those groups and those armies had gone back, even then, you know, the fear was so great that these munafiqeen thought they have not gone. They might come, they might return at any time. وَيَعْتِ الْأَحْزَابَ. And if these armies come back, Yawaddu, they would very much, you know, like. Yawaddu law annahum baduna fil arab. Would that we were among the people of the desert, not at Medina, not facing this situation which we are facing today. Yes, yalunan ambaikum, and from there we would have inquired about the news, what happened at Medina. Walau kanu fikum ma qatalu illa qalila. And if they remain within you, they are not going to fight except a little. Laqad kana, now the reverse, converse side. On the one side is munafiqeen, their nifaq came from their hearts on their tongues. On the other side, laqad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasanatun liman kana yarju Allah wal yawm al akhir wa dhakara Allah kaseera. Verily, indeed, for you there is a best and excellent pattern and ideal and example to be followed in the person of the Prophet of Messenger of Allah. لَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهُ. But only those of you who hope to meet Allah and hope toward the coming of the last day and who remember Allah much, they will be able to avail of this model. Muhammad is a model, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for every mu'min, for every believing person. He should try to emulate him, to follow in his footsteps, to copy him in his seerah and character. This is uswa-e hasana. Laqad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasana. But to be able to avail this uswa-e hasana, to absorb this into your own characters, you have to fulfill number one, liman kana yarjullah, who really believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal yawm al-akhir, and the last day of judgment, wa zakar Allah kaseera, and he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very much. وَلَمَّا رَعَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابِ. Now when the true believers saw those armies, قَالُوا, they said, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. This is what was promised to us by Allah and His Messenger. Why? In Surah Al-Baqarah, just the first surah after Hijrah, that ayah had already been revealed. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. This warning was given to them in the very beginning. We shall test you, we shall try you. Some conditions of khawf, fear. Then, you know, hunger. Then, destruction of property. And even lives. All these things will come in this way. We warned beforehand. So they said, okay, this is the same thing which the Prophet had promised to us. هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. This is that test which has come now, about which the Prophet and Allah had forewarned us. وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. And whatever Allah said was true. And whatever the Messenger said came to be true. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. And this only increased in them in faith and submission. They become more convinced, they became more submissive to Allah's will. Min al-mu'minina rijalun. From among these believers there are men, sadaqu ma'adullah alayh, who have already fulfilled the covenant that they made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa minhum man qada nahbahu. Among them are those who have already fulfilled their vow, that is, they have laid down their lives. They have been martyred in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So their woe is fulfilled. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ And the others are waiting for their turn. When our turn comes, and we also lay down our lives for the cause of Islam, for the cause of the deen of Allah, and our covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fulfilled. وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا And they have made no change in their covenant. لِيَجْزِيَ اللَّهُ الصَّادِقِينَ بِصِدْقِهِمْ So that Allah should give reward to the truthful for their truth. وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ إِنْ شَاءَ And chastise these hypocrites if he likes. أَوْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ And maybe, if he likes, he gives them a chance to apologize, to mend their ways, to change their characters, to become real Muslims and Mu'mins. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا Verily Allah Ta'ala is forgiving and merciful. I told you when we were reading Surah Al-Nisa and Surah Al-Tawbah, that in those two surahs, the door of Tawbah and repenting for the Munafiqeen is declared closed. سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَسْتَغْفَرْتَ لَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ لَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ Now it is equal for them. Whether, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you ask forgiveness of Allah for them or you don't ask. Allah is not going to forgive them. And the ayah, إِن تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةً لَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ Even if you ask Allah's forgiveness for them 70 times, Allah is not going to forgive them. So those doors were closed. But these surahs, Surah Ahzab in the 5th year, Surah Nisa in the 6th year, Surah Tawbah in the 9th and 8th years. So still this time, till the 5th year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept the door of Tawbah and repenting open for the munafiqeen. وَرَدَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِغَيْزِهِمْ And Allah turned back those who disbelieved in Muhammad, the armies that had come. Allah sent them back. بِغَيْزِهِمْ With their own rage. لَمْ يَنَالُوا خَيْرًا They could not have attained any good. They came in full force, 12,000 of them. They had encircled Medina. They kept staying there for a month, but nothing. They could gain nothing. وَكَفَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْقِتَالَ And Allah was sufficient for fighting on behalf of the Muslims, on behalf of the Mu'mins. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ قَوِيًّا عَزِيزًا And verily Allah is strong and mighty. وَأَنزَلَ الَّذِينَ ظَاهَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ مِنْ صَيَاصِيهِمْ Now, another aspect of this Ghazwatul Ahzab was that the last of the three tribes which remained in Yathrib till that time, Banu Qurayza, Banu Qainqa had already gone, Banu Nuzair had already gone. Out of these three tribes, now only one Banu Qurayza was there. And they also broke the covenant and agreement with Muslims. And they sided with the armies which had come out from outside. There was an intrigue and conspiracy. Somehow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the believers and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the evil effects of this conspiracy. But now, when these armies had gone, there's the hadith that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was putting down his armor and his weapons, and Jibreel came to him, alayhi salam, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, you are putting off your weapons and armor. We have not put off our weapons. These Banu Qurayza are to be punished. So the Prophet said to the Muslims, nobody should say the afternoon prayer of Asr without reaching the place of Banu Qurayza. So people went there, then there was, you know, they encircled their township, there were fortresses actually, very strongly built. They had much weapons. They thought that we are very powerful. But then they decided to give up, surrender. There was not a fight. They surrendered, gave up. And the decision they themselves gave to Abdullah Sa'd ibn Ma'az radiallahu anhu, that whatever he decides about us, we shall accept. And he then decided that all the people who can take part in fighting, they should be killed, and the rest of the people should be taken as slaves, and all their properties be confiscated. So this worst, you know, end came to Banu Qurayza. And it is an appendix of the battle of Ahzab. وَأَنزَلَ الَّذِينَ ظَاهَرُوهُمْ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought those people who had sided with them, down from their fortresses, forts and fortresses. وَقَذَفَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الرُّعْبَ, and he cast awe into their hearts. فَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ وَفَرِيقًا وَتَعْصِرُونَ فَرِيقًا. So some of them you are killing, and others you are making slaves. وَعَوْرَسَكُمْ أَرْضَهُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you inherit their lands. وَدِيَارَهُمْ, and their houses and dwellings. وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ, and their wealth and possessions. وَأَرْضًا لَنْ تَتَعُوهَا, and land which you had not trampled under your feet. No fighting took place. Without that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this. And this is, you know, called, one is ghanima. When there is fight, then there is ghanima. But this is another form of booty. And here, you know, it is all for Allah and His Messenger and the poor among the Muslims. It has not to be distributed among the people who took part in the expedition. Now starts that part of the surah which deals with the battles of women and also that special incident of Hazrat Zainab bint Jahsh radiallahu ta'ala anha, Ummul Mu'mineen, because then the Prophet married him. Ya ayyuha an-nabiy qul li azwajika, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to your wives, in kuntunna turidna al-hayata ad-dunya wa zinataha, if you desire the life of this world and the adornment thereof, fata'alaina, so come, umatti'kunna, I give you the comforts of this life, wa usarrihkunna sarahan jameela, and then set you free in a beautiful way, then you can't live in my houses. I have decided faqr for me. I won't have any riches. I won't avail of any facilities or comforts or luxuries. What to speak of luxuries, even comforts. I have to live as a faqir, as the lowest of the believers. Now if you want to live with me as my wives, you have to accept this condition. But if you want, no, we should have facilities and, you know, we should have comforts of life. Now because other believers have also much of the comforts, now they are quite rich. So why shouldn't we be given? So if you decide that, okay, come, I will give you the wealth of this world, but then you will have to depart from my houses. وَإِن كُنْتُنَّ تُرِدْنَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and if you desire Allah and His Messenger, وَالدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ, and the house of the hereafter, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَعَدَّ لِلْمُحْسِنَاتِ مِنْ كُنَّ أَجْرًا عَصِيمًا, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for those amongst you who do good deeds a very mighty reward. Now what was the result? They all said, we prefer Allah and His Messenger, and we accept all these conditions. So there was no parting of ways, even of a single wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O wives of the Prophet, that one of you who commits a manifest indecency, something wrong, and it means, you know, adultery. مَنْ يَعْتِ مِنْكُنَّ بِفَاحِشَةٍ مُبَيَّنَةٍ يُضَافْ لَهَا الْعَذَابُ ضِعْفَيْنِ, she will be punished twice over, because you are wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are living in the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you do, there didn't happen such an incident, not at all, ma'azallah. But you know, the guidance is being given that if you commit something wrong, so you will be punished twice. وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرًا, this is very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that Allah can't do it because you are the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, Allah would do it. And you know, the wife of Hazrat Lut was left behind with the kuffar to taste the chastisement. So this is, you know, if any one of you takes to that path, that would be the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَقْنُطْ مِنْكُنَّ لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, and whosoever among you keeps obedient to Allah and His Messenger, وَتَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا, and keeps on doing good deeds, نُوْتِهَا أَجْرَهَا مَرَّةً, we shall give her reward also twice over. وَآتَرِنَا لَهَا رِزْقًا كَرِيمًا, and we have prepared for them a generous sustenance. Why this twice? Because now you will be the examples for the women of the Muslims. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله اسوة حسنة. Please note, the life and character of Muhammad is an ideal example to be followed by all men. Whether a teacher or a preacher or a fighter or a ruler or a judge, any position, all positions were there which were held by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As father, as husband, any position that you can have in this world, you will find the uswa of Muhammad in that position also. If you are a ruler, Muhammad ruled sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How did he rule? If you are a father, what type of a father Muhammad was sallallahu alaihi wasallam? If you are a husband, what type of a husband Muhammad was sallallahu alaihi wasallam? You have all these examples. If you are you are commanding an army, what type of a commander in chief Muhammad was sallallahu alaihi wasallam? There is no position. If you are an imam of a masjid, Muhammad was imam. If you are a khatib of a masjid, Muhammad was a khatib. If you are a purifier of the souls of the people, he purified the souls of the people. So in any condition you might be, the males, for you complete model is Muhammad. But for women, he is not the complete model. He is not a woman. For the feminine part of their lives and characters, they need model. Now the wives of Muhammad are in that position, model. So if you adopt that exemplary, you know, model character, then you will be given reward for that. So that the women of Ummah, they should follow you. They should follow Aisha, Hafsa, Umm Salama. All these are models for them. So that is why their reward will also going to be double. Ya nisa'an nabiyya lastunna ka'adhi min nisa'in in ittaqaytunna falatakhzana bilqol. O wives of the Prophet, you are not like ordinary women. In ittaqaytunna, if you have the God, fear of God in you, falatakhzana bilqol. Don't be very complacent and soft in your voices, in your saying. فَيَطْمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٌ. So that a person who has some disease in his heart might nourish a desire for you. فَيَطْمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٌ وَقُلْنَ قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفًا. And you should say straight words only. You know, voice of woman also has a sex appeal for the male person. If a woman is speaking very softly, very politely, maybe that a person, if he is diseased himself, he, you know, harbors some hope that perhaps he is inclined towards me. So you have to be harsh. When you address the other men, you should be very harsh, not very soft. وَقَرْنَ فِي بِيُوتِكُنَّا. And stay in your houses. وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَا تَبَرَّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَةِ الْأُولَى. And don't display your adornment like the displaying of the time of the former paganism, when Islam had not come. What was your, you know, what did you do? Women, you know, with the best makeup and best dress, going out to show off to the people, so that people should look towards them. Well, this was the practice of the women over there, in the Jahiliyyah before Islam. Now, Allah is saying, now stop this. Now your social order is going to change. And first to change must be the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. According to the principle, charity begins at home. So the revolution, the social revolution that was coming now in Medina, it started from the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And first of all, they were chastised that you should do this, that this, and this, and this. Not chastised, they were educated and trained. وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَةِ الْأُولَى وَأَقِمْنَ الصَّلَاةَ. Establish prayers. وَأَتِينَ الزَّكَاةَ. And continue paying zakah. وَأَتَيْنَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And obey Allah and His Messenger. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Allah desires to take away from you all abominations and evils, and so that to purify you to the extreme purification. He wants to purify you, O wives of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that you become a befitting model for the women of the Muslim Ummah. وَاسْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And remember what is recited by the Prophet in your houses from the revelations of Allah and the wisdom. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ لَطِيفًا خَبِيرًا. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is subtle and aware. Innal Muslimin. Now this is ayah number 35, which I mentioned in the beginning. Ayah number 35, Surah An-Nur. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ardi Masala Nurihi Kamishkatin Fiha Misbah ila Akhri Laya. The similitude for the Iman in the hearts. Now the Iman is in the hearts. What is the external appearance of that Iman? How it Iman appears in the actions and characters? This is a very, very important ayah, because here, side by side, males and females, repeatedly they are mentioned. That all these things are open, not only for males, not men, all these things are open for women also. And you know, this moral equality between man and woman, Quran, this ayah is the proof of it. Legally, there are differences. The social system, the family system, there are differences. Ar-rijalu qawwamuna 'ala an-nisa. They are the rulers of the household, men, not women. But moral, spiritual, these two things, absolutely, man and woman are equal. Innal muslimina wal muslimat. Verily, the Muslim males and females, wal mu'minina wal mu'minat, and believing men and women, wal qanitina wal qanitat, and obeying men and women, wal sadiqina wal sadiqat, and truthful men and women, wal sabirina wal sabirat, and those who are persevering among the men and the women, wal khashiina wal khashiat, and those men who are humble, and those women who are humble, wasmul mutasaddiqina wal mutasaddiqat, and the charitable men and the charitable women, wasaimina wasaimat, and the men who fast and the fasting women, wal hafizina furujahum, and the men who guard their private parts, wal hafizat, in the same way, the women who guard their private parts, wazakirina Allah kaseeran wazakirat, and those men who remember Allah much, and in the same way, those women who remember Allah much. A'addallahu lahum maghfiratan wa ajran azeema. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for all of them the forgiveness and a very big reward, very honorable and mighty reward. So, have you counted how many are these attributes? Ten. You know, ten qualities for males and females. There's equality. You can achieve. Go ahead. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ أَمْرًا. And it is not behove, it doesn't behove a Muslim woman and a man, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger have decided something, أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ, that they think that they have a choice. Till such time that Allah's command doesn't come, you have a choice, do it or not do it. But when the command comes, you have to do it. Now there's no choice, no option for a mu'min who believes in Allah and His Messenger. وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. And whosoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger, so he or she has gone very far away, astray. Now this is actually, in the background I told you, that when Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wanted that Zainab bint Jahash should be married to Zaid ibn Harisa, neither Zainab was ready to do it, nor the family. But because this was the wish of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they surrendered. So, مَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ. It doesn't behove of a believing man or a believing woman. إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا. When Allah and His Messenger have decided something, أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةَ, that they think even now we have some option. وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. Whosoever disobeys, they said, okay, whatever is the command. And Zainab bint Jahash agreed. But then what happened? They were not going together well. وَإِسْتَقُولُ لِلَّذِي أَرَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. And recall, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, when you were saying to the person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed, وَأَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ, and you also had been very merciful to him, أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ زَوْجَكَ, keep your wife with you, don't divorce. When the news came to the Prophet that Zaid is going to divorce, called him, what are you doing? Keep your wife with you, don't divorce her. وَاتَّقِ اللَّهِ, fear Allah, I compelled her to marry you. Now you are going to divorce. This lot is going to come to her. وَتُخْفِي فِي نَفْسِكَ مَنْ لَاهُ مُبْدِيهِ. And you were hiding in your heart, which Allah was going to make clear, to open. Now from this, you know, the enemies of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they have concocted stories that actually Muhammad had seen Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Hazrat Zainab, when she was taking a bath, and you know, he fell in love with her, and he wanted to marry her. And he actually forced Zaid, when Zaid came to know that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is interested in Zainab, then he decided to divorce. Now this is the story which is being said by these people, Orientalists, etc., etc., who are the enemies of Islam. But it has no truth whatsoever. She was cousin of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Muhammad had seen her coming up of age. She, not that he only when he saw her taking a bath and he fell in love with her, nothing of the sort. And here what was in the heart of Muhammad was only that, but what people say, that she was the wife of his adopted son. How can he marry the wife of an adopted son? Although he has divorced, but she was the wife of the adopted son. And adopted son in their society was just equal to the real son. That was the thing that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was fearing. وَتُخْفِي فِي نَفْسِكَ مَا اللَّهُ مُبْدِيهِ. And you were considering in your mind that which Allah was going to disclose. وَتَخْشَ النَّاسِ. And you were fearing the people. وَاللَّهُ أَحَقُّ أَن تَخْشَوْا. And Allah has more right that you should fear Him. فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِّنْهَا وَتَرَى. When finally Zaid divorced her, زَوَّجْنَا كَهَا. Now we have joined her in marriage to you. This is our command. Now you have to do it. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zawwajnaka, we have given her in marriage to you already. That is why Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha used to say, and so to say, boast to other, you know, wives of the Prophet. You were married here. My marriage was solemnized on the heaven. Your marriages were solemnized on this earth. My marriage was solemnized with Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the heaven. Allah solemnized the marriage. My marriage with Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. زَوَّجْنَا كَهَا لَكَيْ لَا يَكُونَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ حَرَجٌ. So that there should not remain on the believers any blame regarding فِي أَزْوَاجِ أَدْعِيَائِهِمْ, regarding the wives of their adopted sons, إِذَا قَضَوْ مِنْهُنَّ وَتْرَى, when they have divorced them. وَكَانَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ مَفْعُولًا. And definitely the command of Allah had to be fulfilled. مَا كَانَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ مِنْ حَرَجٍ فِي مَا فَرَضَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. There is no blame for the Prophet in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for him. Sunnatullah, sunnatullah fi alladhina khalaw min qabl. This has been the rule of Allah, practice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding those also who were before, all the messengers before you. وَكَانَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ قَدْرًا مَقْدُورًا. And definitely the commandment of Allah is a decree which is absolutely to be obeyed. الَّذِينَ يُبَلِّغُونَ رِسَالَاتِ اللَّهِ. Those who convey the messages of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَيَخْشَوْا, and keep fearing Him. وَلَا يَخْشَوْنَ أَحَدًا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And they don't fear anybody else except Allah. So, oh Muhammad, don't fear. What will they say? Let them say. But you have to do what we have ordained, what we have decided. So that this law, this adopted son's status, that should be finished once for all. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ حَسِيبًا. And Allah suffices as the reckoner. مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ. Muhammad was not father of any of your men. Allah gave only daughters. The sons which he gave to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died in the very early age, infancy. So, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ. He is not the father of any men amongst you. وَلَكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. He is the messenger of Allah. وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. And he is the last, he is the seal of the prophets. No prophet is yet to come after him. So if this rule is not, this wrong rule is not correct, rectified now, who will rectify it? No other messenger is to come in this world. So finally it had to be done by Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. Oh, you who believe, remember Allah very much. وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. And glorify Him in the evenings and mornings. هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ. It is He who sends down His blessings on you, as do His angels also. لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. So that He take you out from the darknesses into light. وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. And He is very merciful for the believers. تَحَيَّتُهُمْ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ سَلَامُ. Their salutation will be when they will meet Him, their Lord, Salaam, peace. وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَرِيمًا. And Allah has prepared for them a very generous reward. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. These are five, you know, positions of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ, O Prophet, we have sent you, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ, number one, شَاهِدًا, to be witness over these people that you have conveyed to them the message that we sent to you. Number one, وَمُبَشِّرًا, and giver of the glad tidings to those who take to the right path. Number three, نَذِيرًا, warning those who reject you that for them hell is waiting. Number four, وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ, and a caller towards Allah by His command. And number five, وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, a luminous lamp which shows way and path to the people at night. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and give glad tidings to the believers. بِأَنَّ لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فَضْلًا كَبِيرًا, that for them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a very big bounty. وَلَا تُطْعِ الْكَافِرِينَ, and don't obey these kafirin, these disbelievers, وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ, in the same way. Don't pay any heed to these hypocrites. وَدَّعْ أَحْزَابَهُمْ, ignore their mischiefs. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ, have your full faith and trust in Allah. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا, and definitely He is the best guardian. And He is sufficient as a guardian. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نَكَحْتُمُ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ طَلَّقْتُمُوهُنَّ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ تَمَسُّوهُنَّ. O believers, when you marry some mu'min women, and then you want to divorce them, before you have even touched them, فَمَا لَكُمْ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ عِدَّةِ. Now you don't have the waiting period to be binding on them, because you have not met. So there is no iddah. تَعْتَدُّونَهَا, that you are going to count, that this iddah should be finished and then she can marry anybody else. No. When you never touched her, so there is no iddah. You divorce and immediately she can marry another husband. فَمَتَّعُوهُنَّ, so now you give them something, some provisions. وَسَرِّحُوهُنَّ سَرَاحًا جَمِيلًا, and then release them from your bond of marriage in a very goodly way. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَحْلَلْنَا لَكَ أَزْوَاجَكَ اللَّاتِي آتَيْتَ أُجُورَهُنَّ. O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, O Prophet, we have declared lawful for you your wives whom you have paid their doors. وَمَا مَلَكَتْ يَمِينُكَ مِمَّا أَفَاءَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. And number two, but those women whom your right hand possesses out of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you as prisoners of war. Number three, وَبَنَاتِ عَمِّكَ, the daughters of your uncles, وَبَنَاتِ عَمَّاتِكَ, and the daughters of your aunts, paternal aunts, وَبَنَاتِ خَالِكَ, and the daughters of your maternal uncle, وَبَنَاتِ خَالَاتِكَ, and the daughters of your maternal aunts, اللَّتِي هَاجَرْنَ مَعَكَ, who have immigrated with you, وَمْرَاتًا, and also, وَمْرَاتًا مُؤْمِنَةً, any mu'min woman, any believing woman, in وَهَبَتْ نَفْسَهَا, if she wants to give and dedicate herself to the service of Nabi, نَفْسَهَا لِلْنَبِيِّ, in أَرَادَ النَّبِيُّ يَنْسَنْ كَيْهَا, if Nabi also wants, the Prophet also wants, desires to wed her, okay, then she is also lawful. خَالِصَةً لَكَ مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. These concessions are exclusively for you, apart from the other believers. خَالِصَةً لَكَ مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. قَدْ عَلِمْنَا مَا فَرَضْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِي أَزْوَاجِهِمْ. We very well know what we have ordained to all the mu'mineen, believers, regarding their wives. وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ, and whatever their right hands possess. لِكَيْلَا يَكُونَ عَلَيْكَ حَرَجْ, So there should be no difficulty on you. You have to work as an administrator, as a ruler. So there are certain reasons why you should have more wives. So actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed all them, they are permissible. Turji man tashau minhunna. You can set aside any one of them if you like. Watuvi ilayhi man tashau, and you can then take and her near to you again if you like. وَمَنِ اتَّوَيَتَ مِمَّنْ أَزَلْتَ فَلَا جُنَحَ عَلَيْكَ. And if you want to bring near to you whom you have set aside, فَلَا جُنَحَ عَلَيْكَ. No blame over you. ذَلِكَ أَدْنَا أَن تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهُنَّ. This is very near and hopeful that their eyes will keep cool. وَلَا يَحْزَنَّ. And they will not grieve. وَيَرْضَيْنَ بِمَا أَتَيْتَهُنَّ كُلَّهُنَّ. And they will keep pleased with what you give all of them. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Allah knows what is in your hearts. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَلِيمًا. And verily Allah is knowing, forbearing. لَا يَهِلُّ لَكَ النِّسَاءُ مِنْ بَعْدُ. But now, this is full stop. Fifth year after Hijrah. Now a full stop was put on the marriages of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now you cannot marry any other woman. لَا يَهِلُّ لَكَ النِّسَاءُ مِنْ بَعْدُ. After today, now no woman is permissible for you to marry. وَلَا تَبَدَّلَ بِهِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكَ وَلَا عَجَبَكَ أُسْنَ. Neither you can exchange, that you divorce one and take somebody else as your marry, as your wife. وَلَا عَجَبَكَ حُسْنُهُنَّ. Although her beauty might please you. إِلَّا مَا مَلَكَتَ أَمَانُكَ. The only exception will remain, except those whom your right hand possesses. There can come, you know, after in the war, in booty, so there can be the, you know, slave girls, but not any wife. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ رَقِيبًا. And verily Allah is ever watcher over everything. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَدْخُلُوا بُيُوتَ النَّبِيِّ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْذَنَ لَكُمْ إِلَىٰ طَعَامٍ غَيْرَ نَاظِرِينَ إِنَاهُ وَلَكِنْ إِذَا دُعِيتُمْ فَادْخُلُوا فَإِذَا طَعِمْتُمْ فَانْتَشِرُوا لَا مُسْتَأْنِسِينَ لِحَدِيثٍ. صدق الله العظيم. O you who believe, don't enter the houses of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْذَنَ لَكُمْ, except when it is permitted to you, or except when you are called for that. إِلَىٰ تَعَامٍ, for some feast. غَيْرَ نَاظِرِينَ إِنَا, not waiting for the preparation of the meals. وَلَكِنْ إِذَا دُعِيتُمْ فَادْخُلُوا. But when you are called, you should enter. فَإِذَا تَعِمْتُمْ فَانْتَشِرُوا. And when you have taken the meals, now you go away, you leave. وَلَا مُسْتَانِسِينَ لِحَدِيثٍ. And don't linger there for some talks. إِنَّ ذَلِكُمْ كَانَ يُوزِنْ نَبِيَّ. This attitude of yours was annoying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَيَسْتَحِي مِنْكُمْ. But he was shy of you. He couldn't say. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَسْتَحِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ. And Allah is not shy from saying whatever is truth. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُنَّ مَتَاعًا. And if you have to ask for something, some goods from the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِ حِجَابٍ. So ask them from behind a curtain. This is very important ayah. And on this is based the concept of hijab, مِنْ وَرَائِ حِجَاب. So a curtain should be there. A curtain, if it is on the door of the house, it is curtain. A curtain before the face of a Muslim woman is the veil. It's also a curtain. ذَلِكُمْ أَطْهَرُ لِقُلُوبِكُمْ وَقُلُوبِهِنَّ. This is purer for your hearts and their hearts. وَمَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَن تُؤْذُوا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَن تَنكِحُوا أَزْوَاجَهُ مِن بَعْدِهِ أَبَدًا. And this is not at all permissible for you, and it doesn't behove of you, that you should annoy the Messenger of Allah, nor that you should marry his wives after him. أَبَدًا, ever. إِنَّ ذَلِكُمْ كَانَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمًا. This is with Allah, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a very great sin. إِن تُبْدُوا شَيْئًا أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ. If you conceal something or you reveal it, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. So it is equal for Allah. Allah knows everything. لَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِنَّ فِي آبَائِهِنَّ. Now when the other believers were stopped from entering the houses of the Prophet ﷺ except when called. Now there is being given a list of the persons, of the relations who are exempted from this stopping of entering into the houses of the Prophet ﷺ. لَا جُنَاهَ عَلَيْهِنَّ فِي آبَائِهِنَّ. There is no blame on them if their fathers, وَلَا أَبْنَائِهِنَّ, or their sons, وَلَا إِخْوَانِهِنَّ, or their brothers, وَلَا أَبْنَائِ إِخْوَانِهِنَّ, or the sons of their brothers, وَلَا أَبْنَائِ أَخَوَاتِهِنَّ, or the sons of their daughters, وَلَا نِسَائِهِنَّ, and not their own women, not strange women, their own women, وَلَا مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُنَّ, and also not for those whom their right hands possess. But a group says that this includes the male slaves also, but some say that only the female, the slave girls. وَاتَّقِينَ اللَّهِ. So these are the people who are allowed to enter the houses of the Prophet ﷺ. And this is the beginning of the list of Mahram. This list is completed in Surah An-Nur. Surah An-Nur was revealed after this, 1 year later than Surah Ahzab. So the beginning is here, but the completion of this commandment of Allah is in Surah An-Nur. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَىٰ كُلِ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدًا. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witness over everything. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَىٰ النَّبِيِّ. Surely Allah and His angels send blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ. O you who believe, you also send your blessings on Him. وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا, and salute Him with a becoming salutation. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Surely who give pain or annoy Allah and His Messenger, لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Allah has cursed them in the life of this world as well as in Akhirah, in the hereafter. وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا, and Allah has prepared for them a very humiliating chastisement. وَالَّذِينَ يُوذُونَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بِغَيْرِ مَكْتَسَبُوا فَقَدْ اِحْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانٌ وَإِسْمًا عَظِيمًا مُبِينًا. And those who give pain to mu'min believers, male believers and women believers, without their having earned that, they have not committed any sin, they have not committed any wrong thing, but people, you know, are saying slanders against them, then such people, فَقَدْ اِحْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانًا, so they have taken upon them a slander, وَإِسْمَ مُبِينًا, very big sin. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِي. O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ لِأَزْوَاجِكَ. Say to your wives, وَبَنَاتِكَ, and your daughters, وَنِسَائِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Now you know this, the commandments are being extended gradually from beyond the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to other women also of the Muslims. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ قُلْ لِأَزْوَاجِكَ وَبَنَاتِكَ وَنِسَائِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Say to your wives, to your daughters, and to the women, and to the wives of the believers, يُدْنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ. They should draw their cloaks over their faces. ذَلَكَ عَدْنَا يُعْرَفْنَا فَلَا يُزَيْنَ. That is, that will be nearer, that they should be recognized, that they belong to respectable families, they are not the slave girls, so that they will not be teased. فَلَا يُزَيْنَ. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And Allah is forgiving and merciful. Now actually in Arabia, before Islam came, there was no segregation of sexes. But the covering of body was okay there. They used to cover their bodies, males and females both. But the women never covered their faces. But it was customary that they had every man and every woman, when he or she went out from the house, they took a long cloth and put them, you know, down them. So, but the women shouldn't, they used it. They are called jalbab. One is khumr. Khumr have been mentioned in Surah An-Nur. وَضْرِبْنَا وَلْيَضْرِبْنَا بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَىٰ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ. These are the scars. We have dupattas in India, in Pakistan, etc. These are khumr. Because they are used in the house. So that is mentioned in Surah An-Nur. Because the rules and etiquettes within the house, they are discussed in Surah An-Nur. But when going out, a bigger, you know, wrapping cloth. But the only thing that was said, that was added to it, was that a part of that, you know, over cloth, you may call it, that should come in front of the face. Yudneen alayhinna min jalabibinna. لَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِ الْمُنَافِقُونَ. If the hypocrites, وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, and those in whose hearts are a disease, they don't resist. وَالْمُرْجِفُونَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ, and those who want to produce commotion in Medina, لَنُغْرِيَنَّكَ بِهِمْ, then we shall urge you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, against them. فَلَا يُجَاوِرُونَكَ فِيهَا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, and then they will not be able to live in this city of Medina after you. You have with you, but very little. Up till now, there was no action was taken against Munafiqeen. The action against Munafiqeen was taken only after the Ghazwa of Tabuk. That was the time when, first of all, the door of repentance was closed to Munafiqun. The Prophet was commanded not to pray for them if they die. Some of the Munafiqeen, the Prophet identified by names and said, go out of our mosque. Then the Prophet burnt their mosque, Masjid Ziraran. And in the same way, because there was no action being taken against them, here it is a threat. If you don't desist from your activities, these type of activities, then maybe we command our Prophet to take an action against you. Maloneen, they are the accursed ones. Aynama suqifu, wherever they may be found. Ukhizu, they should be taken, seized. وَقُتَّلُوا تَقْتِيلًا, and slain, relentlessly, into pieces. سُنَّةَ اللَّهِ فِي الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلُ, and that has been Allah's practice with those who passed away before. وَلَنْ تَجَدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا, and you won't find for the sunnah and law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any change. يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ, people are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the hour. When that as-sa'ah, that qiyamah would come. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, say, the knowledge of that hour is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا, and what shall make you realize that maybe that hour has come very near. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَعَنَ الْكَافِرِينَ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ سَعِيرًا, verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed the disbelievers and prepared for them a flaming fire. خالدين فيها أبدا, they will remain therein forever. لا يجدون وليا ولا نصيرا, they will not find for them any protector nor any helper. يوم تقلب وجوههم في النار, when their faces will be turned from this side to that, from that to this, in the fire. يقولون, and they will say, يا ليتنا أطعنا الله وأطعنا الرسول, oh, would that we had obeyed Allah and would that we had obeyed the Messenger of Allah. وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّا أَطَعْنَا سَادَتَنَا وَكُبَرَانَا فَادَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ, and they will say, oh our Lord, we only obeyed our leaders and our elders, and they led us astray from the right path. رَبَّنَا آتِهِمْ زَيْفَيْنِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ, oh our Lord, give them double chastisement. وَلَعَنْهُمْ لَعَنًا كَبِيرًا, and curse them with a great curse. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ آذَوْا مُوسَى, O you who believe, be not like those who had annoyed or who had said bad things about Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. فَبَرَّهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُوا, but then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleared him off what they said. Now there are stories about this in the ahadith, that because Musa alayhi salam was very shy, so people thought that he has some defect in his body, in his organs. And that is why he's so shy and he keeps, you know, always covered. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, in some way he disclosed to the people, and they could see Musa alayhi salam that he was absolutely healthy and absolutely full. فَبَرَّهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُ وَكَانَ إِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَجِيهًا, and he was in the sight of Allah a very honored person. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. Oh you who believe, have fear of Allah, and say only that thing which is straight and true. Control your tongues. Have the taqwa of Allah in your hearts, and control your tongues. If you do these two things, accomplish these two things, yuslih lakum a'malakum. Allah promises that He will rectify all of your deeds. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And if there are some, you know, mistakes, some sins, some wrong commitments, then He will forgive you. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْضًا عَظِيمًا. And whosoever takes it binding on him to obey Allah and His Messenger, then he indeed has a mighty triumph. He is successful. He has attained a very big success. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَا يَحْمِلْنَهَا. Surely we offered our trust to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they refused to undertake it. وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا, and they were afraid of it. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ, but man undertook it. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Verily he was unjust and foolish. This is one of the most difficult ayat of Quran. And there are many differences in its interpretation. What I understand, may Allah set me right if I am wrong. What I understand is this is the amana of the ruh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which was blown in Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. This ruh, jinnat don't have. This ruh, the animals on this earth don't have. The angels are simply ruh. They are arwah only. They have no bodies. So they have one-sided type of existence. The only creature which has both sides of creation is man. And it was man only who could have that trust of Allah, the ruh of Allah, and hold it. And that is why man was created to be a vice student to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِسْقَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةَ إِنِّي جَعَلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. To a vice student. So actually man, before the roof was blown into him, he was unjust, foolish. He was just an animal. Before this blowing of the spirit of Allah, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. Twice these words have appeared in Quran, in Surah Al-Hijr, in Surah Al-Sad. So when I have fashioned him fully and, you know, given all the finishing touches to him, and then when I blow into him from my own ruh, وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ, then you shall fall down before him in prostration. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ. These words also appear twice in Quran. All the angels prostrated before him. So actually this was this ruh which could be taken by self, by man only and none else. Before that he was an animal. He was not a human being. And as an animal, when Allah says خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, there are two extreme things about man in Quran. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ التَّقْوِيمِ. We have created, you know, a man in the best fashion, best way. But on the other hand, خُلَقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلْ, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, كَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلْ. All these things are there. So why? How do you reconcile? The human being before getting the spirit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was weak, was ajula, was halua. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ كَانَ حَلُوَعَ, حَلُوَعَ عَجُولَ, and he was made out of ajal. All these things were there. But when this ruh was inspired or instilled into him, then he became highest of the highest, higher than the highest. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. أَحْسَنِ, superlative degree. Then we sent him down to the lowest. Without ruh, he is the lowest. With ruh, he is the highest. So this is what I think. So that is why I have translated, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Surely he was unjust and foolish. Not After receiving this print from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these words are not applicable to him. لَيُعَظِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ The end would have been in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What would be the end of all this? Why he created this? Why this creation of life and death? خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا The end would be, لِيُعَظِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ So that Allah should chastise those women who were hypocrite and men who were hypocrite and those men who were associated with Allah, false gods, وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ and those women who were associated with Allah, false gods, وَيَتُوبَ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ And that Allah should lean and relent towards the believing men and women. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا And verily Allah is forgiving, merciful.